How's it going, guys? I've got a Bluetooth speaker we're going to be reviewing today, made by BlitzWolf, model number BW-F2. One of the reasons I wanted to review this speaker is because of the price. You can find these on Amazon. They're going for $26.99, so about $27. And with Christmas right around the corner, this would make the perfect, you know, stocking stuffer or even a gift. You know, at $27, it's very affordable. So I'm hoping that this speaker is worth much more than $27. You know, the website or the manufacturer's website, BlitzWolf.com, shows that it is waterproof. However, the rating is IP65, which means water resistant. So I wouldn't submerge this thing in water. I wouldn't go dunk it in a swimming pool. Although I have read that users have done that. They've submerged in water and nothing happened to the speaker. So although I don't recommend it, at least you have some kind of peace of mind that some users have done it and, you know, the speaker still works. So with it being IP65, what that means is if it rains and, you know, you get the speaker wet, it'll survive that. Or if you accidentally spill something on it, it'll survive that. So this makes it a really good speaker for outdoor use. If you're going out hiking, or, you know, out to the beach, this is the type of product you want to bring along, because it's also shock resistant. So if you drop it, you know, it should be able to survive that. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and unbox this. See what we've got in the package here. There's a speaker there. Pretty straightforward there. Up on top, we've got the power button, volume buttons, play and pause. Let's see here, the strap. Nice silicone strap. You know, it makes it pretty easy to hang on your onto your backpack if you're hiking, or, you know, just hold on to it there and carry it with you if you want. Looks like there is only one area that opens, and that's here on the side. That's where it has a 3.5 millimeter jack, so if you want to plug directly into it, and the micro USB port for charging. And it's also made of that same, looks like a silicone material, to keep it water resistant, nice and tight there. All right, so that's it for this. Oh, there's also a mounting piece here, so I guess you can put that onto a tripod if you wanted to. So that's pretty much it for the speaker there. Inside the package, let's see here. Get the user manual, which when it comes to these speakers, there's not much to them. So I don't expect there to be too much information in here. One other thing I do want to add, it is also a hands-free device in terms of answering phone calls. So you can use this as a speakerphone for your phone. So you can take phone calls right on this thing. So here's the charging cable and micro USB and regular USB on that side, and a aux cord, 3.5 millimeter aux cord. So you can plug it in here and then plug the other side to your phone or whatever device you have that may not be Bluetooth. So that's pretty much it there. Let's go ahead and fire it up. And it's on. Let's connect to it. Light's blinking, so it's letting you know it's ready to connect. And there we go. We're hooked up to it. Like the blue light stopped blinking, so looks like we're ready to go here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fire up a song. I'm going to start it at a relatively low level. Let's make sure we're full blast over here. I think that means we're at full volume. On my computer here, I'm gonna start relatively low so that you know, we don't blow out your ears. So I'm not sure how loud this is gonna come out on the video, so just warning, you know, if you have the video up pretty loud, you might want to turn it down a little for this part of the test. Okay, so I'm at about a quarter on my computer. Sounds really good, by the way. Now we're gonna increase till we hit full volume. That's full volume right there. Now, again, $27 device. That was actually very good for a speaker of that cost. It was very loud. Now, I do want to note that the music did come from this side of the speaker. Nothing comes out of this side, so it's not like a double speaker deal here. It's only coming out of the front end here. Now, as a comparison, just to see how the volume compares here, I got a Jawbone speaker that I'll turn on, and we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna bring the volume down on my computer. We're gonna put this guy all the way up. That's full volume, and play the same song till we reach full volume and see how we compare here. So that's at a quarter. This is at full volume. This is at half. And this is full volume right here. Yeah, much lower. Now this unit here at the time that we purchased it, I believe it was between $80 to $100. This guy's only $27. Volume wise, I can tell you that the BlitzWolf is much louder. We're gonna switch back to it real quick. So I'm gonna play a little bit at full volume out of this guy right now. Now let's quickly switch over to the BlitzWolf and do the same thing, full volume. Night and day there. BlitzWolf is definitely much louder. And at $27, I'm already convinced this is a great speaker. There's a couple other things I want to test out. I want to test how far you can walk away from the unit before it loses its connection. It's supposed to be good up to 30 feet. You know, we'll find out what it can actually do. And also, let's pour some water over it. You know, let's take the water hose and throw some water over it and see what happens. If I ruin it, you know, then at least we know what you can and can't do with it. But if nothing happens to it, then you know definitely it is water resistant. So let's move on to the next couple tests.
We're gonna try out the wetting the device and see what happens. So you can see it there on the floor. It's playing music right now. I'm just gonna take a water hose and kind of simulate what would be kind of like rain. Hopefully you can catch this here. So we're now wetting the device. Soaked up pretty good. Oh, this thing is really wet. Water's starting to really beat down on the sides. Still playing. That is clearly wet. Still playing. No issues. Try the distance test and go in and play some music here. Turn it up a little. Alright, here we go. We're at about 25 feet. And out about 50 feet. Still playing. And we're reaching 100 feet. Clearly still playing. Okay, got a little choppy there. Still playing. Okay, it's getting choppy. Feet. I'm gonna regain its connection. So it claims 30 feet, but we were able to get it to work up to 100 feet, but reliably at 75 feet.
All right, guys, so there you have it. Water resistant, we were able to test that out. We got it very wet. That wasn't an accidental type of test, that we deliberately doused this thing with water, and it's fine. You know, I was able to take a towel, wipe it off, wipe it dry real quick. And one thing to note is the speaker cone did get a little wet. I noticed that. And within a few minutes, it dried out. And I believe it's designed to be able to withstand water as well, in terms of the speaker cone. So it did dry out and still working fine. Distance test, you know, it claims 30 feet. We were able to still have a connection at 100 feet, even though it did start getting a little choppy. But as soon as we came within 75 feet, it regained its connection and it was fine. So reliably, we were able to get out to 75 feet versus the 30 feet that that the specs say that it's good for. One thing to keep in mind, we did have a clear line of sight for the Bluetooth. So anything that gets in the way, like if you're going through walls or just anything that might interfere with the signal, it will cut down the length at which it can operate reliably. For $27 on Amazon, I say this is a definite buy. I would definitely get one, you know, for myself. And again, you know, Christmas is around the corner. Stocking stuffers, perfect for that. And it's also perfect for those that aren't too careful with their devices that may accidentally, you know, get some water on their devices. This will survive. $27, you can't go wrong. This is a really great device. Also, I want to talk about the battery. I believe it's a 2000 milliamp battery. So at a full charge, the website claims that if you keep the volume at 75%, you can get 8 hours of continuous playback on it. So that's something to note there. That's pretty good battery life. So once again, BlitzWolf, BlitzWolf.com, or just go to Amazon and, you know, search for BlitzWolf. Model number is BW-F2, definite buy. And that's my review. Thanks, guys, for watching.